Hello, and welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Franza. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to do a two-way solver table. If you want to know how to install solver table, please see my previous video, and I also have a video on a one-way solver table, so that's the basics, and I would hit those first before going to this one. A two-way solver table is using, you must have the add-on installed first, and you must have the solver table add-on installed. Once you got those in place, what it does is it runs solver multiple times so you can see how you have two variables changing at any one time and see how your optimized solution may or may not change. Okay, let's jump right into it. Okay, here we have our two-way solver table. What we're going to do is we want to solve for total profit. Okay, so simply in this cell F16, I put equals F12. And what do I want to see? I want to see how my unit profit for my laptops, I'm going to make it vary from 400 all the way up to 1,000, and how that varies when I also am going to vary my unit profit for my desktops, which is going to be my column from 500 to 1,200. Okay, so my row is my unit profit for my laptops, and my unit profit for my desktops is going to be my column when I use solver table. Okay, so we already have solver table. The add-on is installed. Let's run solver once, because you do have to run solver once before you can run solver table. You'll notice I'm solving for F12 by changing my changing cells subject to the constraints that the hours I use must be less than or equal to the hours that are available to me. I'm using the simplex method and make sure that we don't have non-negatives. Solver found a solution and everybody's happy. Now that I know that I have that, I'm ready to run solver table. I click and I drag across. See, this is where it's slightly different from a one-way solver table. In a two-way solver table, I have both a row and a column. So I have to stick the information that I want to know all the way up here in this little corner. So I click and drag and highlight, and now I go to my add-ins. I choose solver table. My row, right, this is my row, so it represents my unit profit for my laptops. My column, that's the column right here, represents my unit profit for desktops, or B4. And then I say OK. When I click OK, you're going to watch it. That solver table is going to go boom, 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 and it's going to fill all these in. What it's doing is it's running solver where desktops is 500 and laptops is 400 and solving it. Then it's doing it for desktops 600 and so on and so forth. So watch. Boom. And you see there it goes. Okay, so therefore solver table just did us a big favor and ran solver 56 times for us in a matter of seconds. And that's it. Now when you're analyzing this, what you may want to do, just give yourself a little bit of a, make it a little bit fancier, there we go. You would look at these numbers and you want to see where there's a discrepancy, meaning here, look, from here to here, the difference is 400, 400, 400, 400. 400, 400, 400. So there's nothing really going on. Okay, you're going across, and then let's see here, 400, 400. Well, 400, 400. Okay, so we're looking. But where all of a sudden these there is a jump, that means that my optimal product mix is going to shift. Okay, 300, 300, 300. Wait a minute. Not 300, so there's something going on here. And that helps us to figure out, okay, when my unit profit for my desktops is 500 and my unit profit for my laptops is 800, something over here is going to shift, okay? And it's not going to be 4-3, it's probably going to be something else. Okay, and that is a two-way solver table. Let's just do one more just for the sake of doing it. Over here, I did a little trick. Rather than just putting in 5,800, wouldn't it be great if we could figure out how my optimal solution changes? Well, you can. And in that case, what we're doing is we're just doing something a little bit fancy. You see over here, I have equals. This part, all that does is give me an open parenthesis. It's in between my codes. This ampersand means concatenate. It means it's going to say, okay, give me an open parenthesis and give me what's in cell B12. Then we and give me this comma. And give me what's in C12 and close off my parentheses for me. That's all that this formula does. Okay? Now that we have that, we click and drag across like we did before. We go to our add-ins, we choose solver table, my Rho is still my unit profit for my laptop. My column is my unit profit for my desktop. And let's just scroll down and we say okay. And you'll see it fill on in. And sure enough, before, remember when we were pointing out where does something happen? Well, look here. At 800, 500, like we said before, my optimal solution is changing. It goes from 4.3 to 2.5 and 4. And that's it. That's how you do a two-way solver table. I hope you found this episode of 5 Minutes with Franza. Thank you for watching. Once again, I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza.